Many people with COPD find it hard to have a good sleep because of trouble breathing, coughing, and sometimes just being worried too much about it. If you are struggling with your good quality sleep in COPD, you're not alone. 3 out of 4 people struggle to have good sleep with COPD for many different reasons. So let's talk about why COPD affects sleep and why sleep can affect COPD and why it's important to take measures to improve your sleep for your overall health and your COPD. And at the end, I'm going to give you some tips that might help you get better sleep. Good quality sleep is very important for people with COPD as it helps you conserve your energy, wake up fresh, more energetic the next day. It helps you manage your symptoms, improves your shortness of breath to some degree. Good sleep also affects your mood, your cognitive ability, and helps strengthen your immune system. All of this is very important for better quality of life. When we sleep, we go through different phases of sleep cycle, and one of them is also REM sleep, where our muscles relax a lot. Sometimes people with COPD are using their extra muscles to maintain good levels of oxygen and their breathing, and when they relax, they might drop their oxygen levels or have trouble breathing. Also, not getting enough sleep can increase the levels of inflammation in the body and make our air tubes more irritable for COPD flare-ups. Some common sleep problems that you may be facing are insomnia, which means difficulty falling asleep or taking a long time falling asleep. You may also experience sleep apnea, in which you have episodes where your breathing stops. But there are 2 types of sleep apneas. And sometimes it could be a combination of both. One is obstructive sleep apnea, where people are snoring, have floppy upper airways, and during that time, sometimes their breathing actually stops and their airway is completely blocked. You may see the person is snoring, and then stops. And then there's a pause in their breathing, and then they wake up with a startle and take a deep breath. They might not even know this is happening to them during sleep, but this may disturb their sleep quality and can drop their oxygen levels very low. Another type of sleep apnea is central sleep apnea, in which it's not the snoring that stops you breathing, but something in the brain because of some medications or because of some neurological problems, a stroke or something else, makes people stop breathing during sleep. So all these conditions of sleep apnea should be investigated by physicians. So if you see something like this in yourself or in your partner, then make sure they are seen by a sleep doctor or a pulmonologist to take care of this problem. Another issue could be nocturnal cough. So this could also disturb sleep again and again. So make sure you're on the right medications, you discuss this with your doctors, you practice some mucus clearance before you fall asleep so that you can maximize the chance of getting a good quality sleep. And lastly, you can also have restless leg syndrome, in which you feel that you need this urge to move the legs constantly. This can happen because of iron deficiency, but this can also happen for no other reason, and there are some good effective therapies to help you through this. Now, the good news is that you can make some changes in your life to improve your sleep quality that can make a big difference in how you feel with your COPD. So here are some tips. Number 1, establish a regular routine of going to the bed and waking up. Same time, every day, even on the weekends. Our body likes this internal discipline. Our circadian rhythms, our hormones, all are dependent on our sleep cycle. So if you have a good established routine, it will be easier for you to fall asleep when it's time for sleep. Number 2, create a sleep-friendly environment. Make your environment dark, quiet, and maybe a little cool so that you can easily fall asleep. Number 3 is to practice relaxation techniques, mindful breathing, relaxation exercises, light reading, and maybe some little light stretching can also make you prepared for a good sleep. Number 4, keep your head a bit elevated, maybe about 30 degrees or 40 degrees if you can. This will help you breathe better and give your diaphragm a good chance of helping you breathe easier. This also may help you reduce some of the coughing. You may also feel that sleeping on your side helps you reduce some of the coughing as well. Number 5, avoid any stimulants right before you sleep. Especially make sure you don't have any caffeine 6 to 8 hours before your bedtime. Similarly, limit the use of nicotine and alcohol as well. Number 6, stay active in the daytime. Engage in physical activities, house chores, and other activities so that when you are going to bed, your body is ready for good rest. but avoid exercising 2 hours before you go to bed. Lastly, and very importantly, make sure you follow your COPD treatment plan, which means take care of your medications, use your inhalers correctly, appropriately, and regularly, and also use oxygen therapy if that's prescribed to you. With all these efforts and things, if you're still struggling with any of your sleep problems, then make sure you talk to your doctor and get the right care. You may be having a problem that needs some extra interventions and extra therapies or a sleep study to investigate further. I hope this video was beneficial for you to understand that how important sleep is in your overall life quality and your COPD management, and you were able to take away some things that will help you improve your sleep or seek the right care at the right time. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again with more COPD tips. Gain better control of your breathing through PEP Buddy, your personal breathing coach.